Today, I'm going to introduce a new video editing model called Ditto. Its editing method is very straightforward. You only need a string of commands prompts to complete high-quality editing of a video. This model supports both what we call global editing and local editing. Global editing, of course, refers to redrawing the entire scene at an overall level. For example, modifying the style of the entire video is a common form of global editing. Local editing, on the other hand, involves things like adding an object to the video or modifying aspects of a character's appearance or clothing. This falls under the scope of local editing. What you are seeing now is the Ditto homepage on GitHub. The Ditto model was trained based on the 1.2.1 T2V14B model. Therefore, if you want to use it, you must download this base model first. The official source also provides very detailed instructions on how to use this model within ComfyUI. First of all, we need to download the corresponding auxiliary models. This includes our 1.2.1 T2V14B model, as well as our acceleration model, like COSVID, the VAE, and the text encoder. Theoretically, everyone should already have the VAE and text encoder downloaded. Most importantly, you can download the Ditto model itself from their Google Drive or Hugging Face. There's a very interesting explanation here. Please take a look. You need to load this model in the form of a vase module. In Kijai's workflow, Virginia CE's connected externally to the main model as a module. This utilizes the same mechanism. Therefore, if you want to use this workflow, you also need to use Kijai's WAN video extension as the main model. Of course, there are also some auxiliary extensions. Next, let's look at how to use it. Pay attention. There's an example workflow here. I have also built this workflow on Running Hub. You can access this platform through Running Hub in the ComfyUI space. Running Hub is an excellent online working platform because whenever new technologies or extensions appear, they follow up immediately. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description. This will grant you 1,000 free points. Additionally, you will receive 100 bonus points every day you log into Running Hub. This allows you to try out your own workflows. All right, next we will look at the specific usage of the Ditto model. Let's first look at the effect of the first workflow. This video is one we generated previously, featuring an oriental beauty walking in a cherry blossom forest. Using a single prompt, I can generate a similar effect. The reason we use this workflow as the first example is to alleviate a common concern. This model is not simply limited to style transfer effects. Look, both styles here are realistic. The basic scene and composition are the same. However, with one prompt, we can transform the initial video into the resulting video. This confirms its capability to perform video editing. Next, let's analyze the workflow. This workflow is actually very similar to Vase. The workflow you see is my reconstructed version. I reorganized it to make the structure clearer. Okay, let's first look at loading the main model. Loading the main model primarily involves the model's three components. Our main model is the 1.2.1 text-to-video model, which is an FB8 model. We also need many auxiliary models. First is our COSVID. We have discussed the COSVID model before. It is mainly used for acceleration. We also enabled block swapping. Note that I have activated 38 blocks here. This is the main model we downloaded. As mentioned, you can download the model from the official Hugging Face or Google Drive. However, there are quite a few models. Take a look. There are currently three models available. Although we mentioned that Ditto supports both global and local editing, currently in ComfyUI only global editing is supported. So these three models are all for global editing. However, the focus of these three models differs. The first one is a global editing model with relatively balanced capabilities. The second model focuses more on style transfer. The third model is better at converting non-realistic videos into realistic videos. Therefore, we typically just use the first one. This is the main model you are currently seeing. Following that are our VAE and our encoder. Since we have used these many times, I won't go into detail. Please note that this model is connected to the main model in the form of Vase. This is the connection method mentioned earlier. Here's our original video. It is best if we resize it. I currently set the resolution to 832 by 480. Then, we perform a VAE encode to generate a VAE embedded vector, which is then used for sampling. The prompt instructs the model to turn the person in the video into a gorgeously dressed woman, someone with very elaborate clothing. The sampling process is not significantly different from the regular 1.2.1 model. The sampling steps are set to 4. You should try to follow the default settings and proceed. After decoding, you can see the result. It is very beautiful. Indeed, she has been transformed into a noblewoman with luxurious attire. Next, let's look at the second example. This prompt instructs the conversion of the original video into a pixel-style video. Let's check the result. This conversion is highly successful, and all the details have been preserved. However, you should note that the scene where the cherry blossoms fall is not reflected here. This is what we commonly refer to as style transfer. Even for this functionality, you will notice that Ditto performs much better than many models we have seen before. Let's test another one, take a look. This style is actually quite uncommon. Even if you try to achieve it using other videos, the difficulty is relatively high. This is a pencil sketch style. The entire workflow is the same. We changed the prompt to convert the original video into a pencil drawing style video. There wasn't much descriptive prompting. Let's look at the quality of this conversion. It is still very high. As we mentioned earlier, style transfer is only one aspect. You can also perform global editing on the video. Let's look at this one. This prompt is intended to transform the environment into a mysterious and relatively dark image. There will be a witch here, and she has green eyes and is wearing black and gold armor. Looking at the overall editing result, you will find it is a dark style video. There is green energy. She is wearing gold armor and black clothes. Even the umbrella has turned black, and her eyes are glowing green. Therefore, this is not merely simple style transfer. It truly is video editing. This is also a style conversion, transforming it into an anime style. However, this is only a visual feeling. My prompt was actually an edit, including what the person should look like and how their image should change. While it visually feels like style transfer, if you look closely, you will find differences. For example, the hair color has definitely changed, and the hairstyle has also changed. In pure style transfer, the person's overall attire would not typically change. Finally, let's look at this most unique example. Take a look. I actually transformed the character into the style of a marble sculpture. This is quite rare. Look at the quality of this conversion. It is truly astonishing. Very few models can achieve such fine-grained editing. And remember, this is only global editing. I believe that once local editing is also supported later, it may bring us even more surprises. Through these examples, you will also notice that writing effective prompts is extremely important. The official source also provides many examples here. You can see various editing methods. In fact, most of these methods are still based on style transfer. You can choose the ones you are interested in and test the overall effect. Currently, Kijai's One Video extension is also trying to support this model. The basic functionality has actually been implemented, but its method of support is slightly different. You can open its model list on Hugging Face. Under the Lora directory, we can find a folder named Ditto. If you open it, you will find that there are Ditto models here as well. However, notice that they exist in the form of Lora, so Kijai intends to incorporate it into the workflow in a more lightweight manner. For the official approach, the 6GB model is indeed quite large. However, Kijai has not yet provided an example workflow. Once Kijai updates this workflow, we will demonstrate its basic usage in the Lora format. I personally feel that this workflow is highly innovative and brings us huge surprises. What are you waiting for? Go ahead and try it yourself. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.